First day of the bouldering, highball bouldering trip to Northumberland.
Northumberland. On Blake Law Farm, a couple of sheep, couple of pads. I'm glad we got our wellies out to kind of fit the part of the farm.
Oh yeah. Yeah, we look like farmers who are carrying massive mattresses on their back.
That looks like a... What the?
That scared the shit out of me.
What the hell is that?
That's terrifying.
It's like a fusion between a sheep and a bulldog.
Yeah! A full sheep.
See what 6C feels like after those 5 pluses.
Yeah, the 5 pluses felt like 6C's like.
They're pretty hard.
Nice.
My little friend I found is a beetle. They call him Paul McCartney.
Paul McCartney?
He's a beetle.
I'm like a fucking shitting dog.
Oh fuck!
How's it felt? It was really good. It was kind of okay.
Yeah,
just a bit like sketchy, like pulling off that like pocket. Like one finger is good, and then the fingers kind of just nestled inside. It's like,
come on.
But then you get that last one, like,
come on,
Rich. It was good. Yeah. Jesus Christ! Oh my God!
Did you see my hand slipped? Shut up! Oh my God!
I don't know if that's scarier for him
or me.
My heart's going.
Oh my God! How terrifying!
Hi Robbie, what have you moved back onto? Some nice boulder, I presume, some nice... Come on, it's coming to the evening, so we'll hop on some nice, easy boulders, yeah? Safe boulders.
So, yeah, I don't know, this is like an E6, 6B trad route, which I'm going to try and...
Ground up with boulder pads.
Yeah, it looks very green, and it might not have been climbed very recently, and I don't have rope, so I can't check.
Yeah,
but see, I can't clean it or anything.
To be fair, with a rope, you see that in-situ gear? It's a spore climb.
Oh my god, that was terrifying.
Took a little fall there.
Ooh.
Well, let's see it.
This thing here broke off. Jeez.
I think Mark got more of a fright than you.
I did get a fright. Usually I'm pretty good at photographing people falling, and that one I just... I got such a shock.
It's such a pop.
Scary at the top there, because like I hadn't checked out those moves at all, and I was just like this, like all the holds were kind of like dirty and they had the scraggly stuff all over them. They're quite positive holds though, and then there was this tiny little button that I just had to trust my foot on, and I just was shitting it. I just didn't want to trust it, considering the last hold was a much bigger foothold and I just broken off. I was like, and I'm like double the height up here, I was like, I don't really want to trust that thing, but I did and it worked. Yay! Recording, take one. Culann falling off highball boulder prop.
Maybe one.
So we're here at another Northumbrian crag. This one is called Shitlington. It's a good name for a crag. Shitlington.
Shit
little thing. But it's definitely not shit. It's got some epic highball boulder problems. In the background here, we've got Mark Savage.
This crag should be called Amazelington.
Amazelington!
Amaze big thing.
That's Amaze big thing.
Spend a lifetime waiting.
Kremlin, which is not in Russia, but is actually in Northumberland.
It was 30 years between Bob and Dan climbing it. So we waited 30 years for a repeat, and in that time it built up quite a mystique.
So it's like font 7B plus boulder problem, and it was done, what, like in the 80s?
Yeah. Or,
yeah, something like that.
Yeah. Punched up crooks. Harder than it looks. Certainly harder than the grade suggests, I think.
That was exciting.
That was so good. It was like just what was needed, you know, after doing that hard boulder problem, just a bit of sketch,
yes.
A wee bit of faff. You know, you just got to have that for these sorts of climbs. Just a wee bit, but it was good.
But it was necessary faff.
Necessary faff.
Yeah, and you're looking a bit tired, to be honest. You look like you could do something.
I could do something.
You could do something.
I could do with a mochi break! Mochi.
How's your mochi?
Oh, so good. I love mochi.
Mm.
Like, the mochi break doesn't always have to be crazy, lads, and sometimes you have to be okay with us just having a chillax mochi break. Yeah. We're just trying to bring you entertainment while being us, and we're not always going to try to be energetic and all up in your face.
We're trying to be authentic here, you know? We're not going to be one of those people who are just doing things for the likes or for the follows. We're not
for
like that,
Instagram.
You know? We're authentic people. We're human beings.
We're real feelings.
We're just doing what we do.
What type of mochi is this?
This is red bean mochi.
Yeah.
So good.
So it's a Japanese sweet with filling. Pretty delicious filling.
Mm. But you know, one thing that makes me think about this, you know, what mochi really makes me think about, how lucky we are to live in a society that, you know, imports quality Japanese, you know, products, not just Japanese, but products from lots of different countries all over the world to us so that we can enjoy this beautiful snack. I mean, I can't say for you, but my parents, my grandparents, they definitely wouldn't have,
Let's see your technique for getting it on, Callan.
If your leg is strong, man, don't scratch the van. Jesus, I'm sweaty from that.
Right, we're going to go to Ravenshoe, which is meant to be the classic highball venue of Northumberland. So we need to take the mats. Ba-boom.
Hey guys, how long have we been walking?
Fucking, oh, like
3 minutes.
Yeah, for a really good 3 minutes. It's currently, let's give some context, it's currently 22 degrees or thereabouts. It's a bit, we're in the jungle, so it's nice and moist in the air. The bags are heavy. You have camera gear, pads, ropes, gear.
The life of a YouTuber.
Yeah.
What's this? I've got my poles to help me.
That would be so impressive.
Yes! That was heroic. Oh man, I felt good doing that.
Leg day.
Never skip leg day. Oh, we made it! It only took us forever. Wow.
We were literally about 15 meters on the path up there, wandering around, crying, ringing Mark.
So lost.
Yeah. And it was good.
Here the entire time.
Missed it!
Oh, did you do it? Come on. That's it.
Like that pocket thing that you wear left hand, it feels like you're like in a pocket, but you're not sure is the outer wall actually rock because there's so much moss there.
Yeah, you're actually holding moss.
Yeah.
Over the jug, and just hoping the moss doesn't peel off in a massive
really
layer.
Really good moss though. Really.
Yeah, solid bomber moss.
Hey.
Yo.
What are we on?
We are on the Reaver, which I think it's another Bob Smith route. It's this thing here. Given E760 back in the day, probably given font 7B plus for highballing it.
If you say Reaver, it just sounds like you're saying river in a Scottish accent.
The Reaver.
Reaver. No, that's
the Reaver.
River.
Oh, okay, there you go.
Go down the Reaver there.
Maybe it's
that's
Irish.
That sounds like a Spanish. I hate the Reaver or something.
Spanish.
Le Reaver.
The Reaver.
Go down El Reaver. Follow him down the El Reaver.
Go down to the river.
It sounds like a classic Mexican accent. Nice.
When I saw you downtown. Where am I going?
Fuck yeah, high point.
Ah! This is like brushing your teeth in the morning. I'm just gonna like put on the toothpaste. More chalk.
Fun fact, Robbie hasn't brushed his teeth in 5 years.
Well, I have brushed my teeth, but with chalk.
Yeah.
It's magnesium, good for the teeth.
Yeah. Friction Labs chalk is a teeth whitener.
Only the unicorn dust.
Gorillas have strong teeth, I hear, though.
Yes.
Actually,
and horses.
They actually would have really strong teeth, wouldn't they?
Whoa. Woo!
Oh.
Here is crazy.
Where's freaking Reaver?
The Reaver is proving to be a worthy adversary for a highball.
We're kind of going ground up, as in we cleaned the holes. Well, Robbie cleaned the holes from the top down.
Yeah, abseiling in. Just cleaned the holes.
Well, you didn't
try
work,
the moves.
Yeah,
no.
You didn't work. So it's technically.
We had to do that because it was just so dirty.
Yeah.
You know, it hadn't been climbed probably in a while, and it doesn't get much sun around here, so the rock does just get like totally minged up.
Well, we're definitely trying the moves ground up.
Yeah. So, yeah. Look at it now. Now it's got some chalk on it. It looks like a beautiful piece of rock. Woo!
Nice.
Watch me.
Nice. Watch
me here.
Oh.
So bad.
It's like,
fuck you. Why did I choke? Fuck you. I thought I had on good enough to choke. I did not.
Come on.
Yes, come on. Come on. Right,
so,
yeah.
That's it.
Come on. Come on,
dude. There, and to the west.
That's it.
Yeah,
nice.
Come on, Robbie.
Yeah. Oh my god. That was a little bit scary.
Come on.
What I think happened is Robbie tried to fucking kill me. Robbie threw a block at me.
Oh, yeah.
He was lay down next to the block, Mary, so you get a comparison.
It's the size of me.
About a Mary sized block. I was standing here, but then Robbie started falling this way. I didn't even know a rock was falling, so I jumped and threw a pad under his feet. So my kindness saved me.
Yeah, I saved your life.
Yeah.
Boys are back in Ravens too, huh?
Yo, and welcome highballers for another fun-filled day of highballing adventures. We are currently looking at this highball here, which is an E5 trad root, which has no gear, so it's highball. Don't know what boulder grade it is. It's called Plumber.
The Plumber.
What are you doing, Robbie?
I'm just gonna wrap down this line and just clean it up a bit.
Oh, so it's not ground up.
Well,
Robbie Phillips is bailing off a HVS.
Did you want a fucking glove it?
No, I fucking love you, Robbie. A professional climber, more like professional cleaner. Yeah, so warm. It's so warm.
It's like I'm having a really...
Jesus Christ! Fuck! I'm alive, I just fucking nearly died. I just fucking fell. I was sunbathing, look where I fell. Jesus!
Thank you.
calling it an hour at least anyway on the E5. Chickened out twice. Well, the second time I fell, but I think I kind of wanted to fall. I just, my head was not in the route at fucking all. It just, the psych wasn't there, and I think for highballs you have to be especially psyched to actually want to get up the route, or else you just leave the nerves get to you, which I let do. So now we'll go do another E5 and I'll try to get my head back. I've lost it. Fucking ravens, he was taking my head. Sight. Oh, that's a brilliant climb.
How was that?
That's fantastic. Definitely my highest high ball. It's fucking high. I got to the top and I had to make sure to remind myself, because I got to the jugs and I was like, yeah, I know I'm in jugs. I had to remind myself, I was like, I'm still a fucking long way off. Man, you spot me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll start so. I don't know why they call it highball, and you're already fairly close to the top part. God, I just wanted that to be done. The moves were so not bad. I just, the mental battle is over.
Yes.
Fuck that route. Fucking one star route.
So Colin's about to try and on-site or flash a highball boulder problem that Johnny Dawes put up.
Yeah, I've never climbed a Dawes route before. Pretty exciting. Confidence is not high, but you know, feeling good.
Yeah. You should try and do it Johnny Dawes style without using your hands.
Okay, yeah, and like really kicky, floaty, dancy feet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Very stylish.
Oh, my fucking knee! Yeah.
Great start.
Daddy's struggles are really bad. Fucking Jesus! I mean, this is what you kind of expected Dawes route, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just shitty feet.
I mean, that and the fact that the feet are green. Took me the best part of, I don't know, the last hour to clean this and it's still dirty.
That's so hard.
Yeah.
Thank you.
quite like this flat light.
Yeah, not too hot either. It's quite nice back here. Even in the midges route back here, wasn't too bad.
Mm. Come on.
Come on.
Come on. Oh my god!
Yeah.
What the fuck happened?
I've got no recollection. Jesus.
Not prepared for this. It's flat to your right.
Oh, Jesus.
So this Johnny Dawes thing turned out to be a little bit harder than we expected. The start was super nailed, but the top section, although it's not hard climbing, still very technical, very balancey. And just like scrittly rock. It's classic Northumbrian sandstone when it hasn't really been cleaned properly. So I've given it a good scrub. I've got it as close to clean as I can possibly get. And I think I'm gonna go for it now. I'm feeling a bit nervous. So I'm just gonna try and keep my head together. Got loads of pads, but it's that kind of like, it's highball, just kind of just verging onto the sort of high highballs.
That one's a bit easier, isn't it?